For many years, we have set our cultivation protocols, decided when to irrigate, or how to address challenges in our plantations. And now it is time for change.
The plant have a solution. We just have to listen.
Basically, for us, this project is a great opportunity to test for the first time in a field a technology that we have been developing within our research lab since many years. Plants do have electrical properties, electrical activities within their tissues, and we started to understand whether electrical activity can somehow correlate with the lack of water. The point is that you can detect it only with very, very accurate instruments that works only inside the laboratories. So the main challenge here is to create something that is low cost, easy to install, easy to use, and that can stand outside with the external environment.
We are in Tanzania, we are in a province of Mbeya, in the farm of Utengule. Tanzania for us is one of the origin county for coffee. For academia, it's important to have a reference on the field.
So first we go now to a coffee field that is flowering. And then we go to nursery. We have 300 hectares total, 135 R coffee. If you make 70 liters per square meter and a hectare has 10,000 square meter, you get into massive amounts of water you need to do the flowering. At the moment, we use about 1,000 cubic meter a day, 1 million liters a day. You know, 10, 20 years ago, there was no water problem here. But now, due to deforestation, which you don't see here, just above this hill, it's clean shaving. The rainy season has over the years gone shorter. It comes later. It ends more or less the same, but it arrives later.
Quindi dovremo preparare una distribuzione omogenea nei due plot di queste due tipologie di sensore, perché noi in mezzo alla scelta delle piante da cui mettiamo I nostri misuratori di linfa.
Abbiamo 24 sensori di umidità.
Esatto, probabilmente dovremo scavare a 30 cm, anche 50 cm per posizionare I sensori dell'umidità. The main goal of this project to me is to be able to develop something that will give the plant the voice to tell us when they will need water. Basically those shade trees will affect only two here. Maybe that one and that one, so they will be somewhere outside here.
So we took a field which is about 10 years old and with a productive variety on a fairly good location, and it obviously couldn't be too far away for technical reasons, you know, transmission of data. And there are about 120 trees in there. That's why we have chosen that field.
Each plant will be equipped with four little electrodes that are like needles that will be inserted within the trunk. And with the devices, we will record these signals along the day and during the night. So what we expect is to have some waves, so that signals will go up during the day and then will go down slowly during the night. Just because it's basically we are monitoring the daily activity of the plant. When the plant won't have water, those signals will be reduced and reduced and reduced because the plant will have to almost stop his activity in order to survive without water.
Innovation is tremendously important. We have to think at better ways of doing agriculture. One can see the women picking coffee, delivering the cherry to the mill. Here, those two guys, they are washing in the washing channel. Then here, one can see the guys, they're doing the picking of any not perfect bean out of here. So it's now 104 years that this farm, this land grows coffee. So the way we grow coffee now in new fields is totally different from the way we did even 20 years ago.
We are also installing humidity sensors. There are two types of humidity sensors. Small ones that will be inserted at approximately 30 centimeters below ground. And some big multi-depth sensors that are able to scan up to 80 centimeters the humidity of the soil. So we will create a very accurate humidity map of the soil, and we will match it with the information that we are gathering from the plants thanks to the electrical sensors. And by crossing and analyzing those two sets of data, we will be able to calibrate the sensors to interpret and anticipate the need for water for the plant.
We have several rivers coming down from the hills up there. Here for the Itimba fields and Utengule fields, we take it from the river coming down next to the factory. And that one dries up for about 3 to 4 months a year. There's no water. Water is the biggest problem here on the coffee plantation. Per year we have this year a bit more than 1,000 millimeters of rain, and that's not enough for Arabica. We need more. If we couldn't do irrigation, coffee farming here would not be possible.
This is one of the problems that the climate change has in this moment.
And the main aim of this project is to understand the optimal quantity and when we need to irrigate. This will help to optimize a lot the water resource.
Taking action needs knowledge. Sensor project will be a very advanced tool to predict, to analyze, get the data, and give us a better way of managing our coffee fields.
Now I think it's a moment the industry of coffee have to be connected to the cultivation and to the processing. This is so important to have this kind of elements to improve the coffee in the cup.
I've been always fascinated by plants, but to me what is more interesting is to understand their mechanisms, how they adapted to solve daily problems. And the strategies that they are able to develop are so fascinating that I cannot stop to study them. They will express new ways of face environmental changes.
The plants tell us. They show us their needs, their vulnerabilities, and we cannot ignore them. It will be the plant silently asking us for what it requires and manifesting the effects of climate change. It's a climate that's no longer the same as it used to be. The plant will demonstrate the significant help it provides in reducing the effects of global warming. It will always stand by our side, and we cannot do without it.